This is a part 3 of your geography chapter number 2, Physical Features of India. So, in our second part, we have studied about Northern Plains. Northern Plains are categorized according to three river system, that is Indus River, Ganga River and Brahmaputra River. Then we had studied about the Peninsular Plateau. Peninsular Plateau is categorized into two parts, Central Highland and Deccan Plateau. And also it is categorized into Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. This thing we have studied. Now, today we will take the topic of Indian desert. So, see students, this is the image of a desert. How desert looks. Now, the Indian desert. So, you all know our Indian desert is located in Rajasthan and it is called as a Thar desert, a great Indian desert. So, Indian desert lies towards where here, in western margin of the Aravalli Hills, is an unadulting sandy plains covered with sand dunes. So, here the whole this Thar desert has a sandy plain. Wherever you go, you will see sand, sand, sand. And you can see the sand dunes also. So, this region receives very less rainfall, below 150 mm per year. It has an arid climate, means very, very dry climate with a low vegetation cover. Here, cactus are only growing, no vegetation. But with the help of irrigation, we can grow some crops like jowar, bajra and maize. So, stream appears during the rainy season, means during the monsoon season we can see some streams, they are appearing, but after monsoon season it disappeared. So there is only a one river and a very large river in this Thar desert. It is the river Luni. Now students, we will study about the coastal area of India. So, see, the black mark in this map is the coastal area of our India. Now, the Peninsular Plateau is flanked by stretch of narrow coastal strip. Flank means it's divided into a narrow coastal strip. So, running along the Arabian Sea on the west and Bay of Bengal on the east. The western coast sandwiched between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea, and it is a very narrow plain. It consists of three sections. This western coast is have a three section. The north part is called the Konkan, means Mumbai to Goa, and the central stretch is known as a Kannur plain, while the southern stretch is referred to as a Malwara coast. As you see here, the Konkan coast, Kannada coast and this Kanyakumari coast, means Malabara coast. Now, the plain along with the Bay of Bengal are wide and level. So, in the northern part, it refers to the northern Sikar, while the southern part is known as a Coromandel coast. You had studied in your English. One poem is there about the Coromandel coast. So, there is a large river such as Mahanadi, the Godavari, the Krishna, the Kaveri, where formed the extensive delta, means a very delta is very large on this coast. So, Lake Chilka is also an important feature along the eastern coast. But now, the Chilka Lake is submerged into Bay of Bengal. Okay, so this is a picture of the island, one of the island of Andaman Nicobar. So we will start with our new topic about the Indian islands. So students, you know how many islands are there in our India? It is two islands. One is Lakshadweep Island and second is Andaman Nicobar Island. So first we will study about Andaman Nicobar Island. As you see here in map, that Lakshadweep Island is scattered you see here. And this island is a group close to a Malabar coast of Kerala. This group island is composed of small coral island. Why Lakshadweep island is called a coral island? One aquatic animal is there, its name is coral. With the skeleton of this aquatic animal, this whole island is there. So earlier they are known as Lakadives. Lakshadweep island is called as a Lakadives, Minicoy or a Amindai. In 1973, these were named, all these are named as a Lakshadweep island. It covers a small area of square feet, 32 square kilometer. And Karavati island is the administrative headquarter of Lakshadweep island. Karavati island is the capital of Lakshadweep island. So this island group has a great diversity of flora and fauna. Here you see the beautiful garden, flowers, vegetations, plants and varieties of animals. And the Piti island, which is uninhabited and has a bird sanctuary. Here you can see the variety of birds. Now we will see about the Andaman Nicobar Island. See here how Andaman Nicobar Island is also a scattered. Andaman is another and Nicobar is another island. Both are different island. And this is a elongated chain. This is one kind of chain which we can see. And it is located in Bay of Bengal from north to south. So, these are the Andaman and Nicobar Island. They are bigger in size and are more and are numerous. But all islands are scattered here, as you see here in the map. So, this entire island is divided into two groups. Andaman in the north and Nicobar in the south. So, it is believed that this island is an elevated portion of submarine mountain. What is called the elevated portion of submarine mountain? Some mountain are submerged in the Bay of Bengal and the top part of these mountains are there. That's why the Andaman Nicobar Island is considered as a elevated portion of submarine mountains. So, this island group are strategic, very important. How they are important? Because there is a great diversity of flora and fauna. And this island have close to equator also. So, it experience a equatorial climate and have a very thick forest cover. Means it is a densely forest area. And here the monsoon is more than 200 centimeter. So, students, thank you. Here I had covered the whole chapter number 2, Physical Features of India.